Hey guys, today I will show you how to retrofit RDC, Rafe and Drew control, or the tire pressure monitoring system in English. I did this upgrade years ago, so this video will be a combo of video footage and photos. I like this upgrade since the sensors are quite precise and have a deviation of 10-15%. And you have a nice tire pressure visual on the screen. Installation is not that difficult. We need to install wheel sensors, a control module underneath the car, run 4 wires into the trunk and do some coding. Let's start. Sensors were installed beforehand by the tire shop during the standard tire renewal. Now we need to install the control module and run some wiring. Try to buy the module of the latest revision. Mine is exactly the latest model. This is what will be required. A control module, module's bracket, plastic nuts, connector plug, plug pins, plug wire waterproof grommets, negative cable pin, positive cable pin, 5 amp fuse, 2 pins for tapping into the can wiring. Let's install the module first. Remove the rear right wheel. Install the module bracket using the plastic nuts. Nut threads already exist on the car. Undo few wheel arch trim bolts and move it aside for job convenience. Now we need to assemble the connector plug together with some wiring and run it to the trunk through this rubber grommet. As you can see from the schematic, there are only 4 wires. Supply wire, negative wire and 2 CAN bus wires. All of them are 0.5 square millimeter thickness. Now we need to assemble the connector plug, mount the waterproof grommets on the cable and crimp the pins. Insert the pins into the connector plug. Plug pinholes have numbers. Insert the positive wire to hole number 2. Negative wire to hole number 4, CAN high wire into hole number 3 and the CAN low to number 1. Wrap the outside part of the wiring with the waterproof tape and the inside trunk part with the soft tape. The 2 CAN bus wires should be twisted like this. Wire should be long enough to run along this cable route and reach the fuse box and the negative cable connector. This is where my positive wire plugged into the designated spot and the negative wire as well. The CAN bus wire connections are buried somewhere here. I have already rewrapped the cable route with the fresh tape. Now let's disassemble the trunk trim and remove the fuse box. Remove this fuse block and unlatch the fuse blocker to be able to insert the fuse pin. The pin goes to fuse number 139. Insert the new fuse. Now insert the negative wire pin into the negative wire point. Now it's only remaining to tap the CAN wires into the vehicle's CAN wiring. You have to find the twisted CAN wire pair in this wire bundle. One wire should be green and the other one is orange with green stripe. The green one should be tapped to the wire which goes to the pin number 1 of the module plug and the orange green to the pin number 3. Now it is time to do some coding. I will connect my battery charger and set it into the supply mode while coding. I will use ECs for the coding job. Connect to the car and follow my steps. Now we will need to add a new option into the vehicle order, to Victor Bravo. As you can see, it is already there, since this option is retrofitted. You would need to write a comma and 2VB and press apply. Now follow the further steps. Select our saved file. Now read all the modules. We will need to code several modules with the new vehicle order: ICM, Combi, DSC, and Multimedia, like NBT, CEC, etc., and the RDC module itself. I will show you the ICM as an example. Just press code and wait for the process to be finished. One more thing, if the RDC module will not have the CAFD file, like in this example, then press the Detect CAF for SWE button and select the latest bottom line. Then you could code the module. If the pressures and the temperatures will not be visible in the screen, you would need to FDL code few extra strings. For this purpose, you would need a launcher or a beamer code or similar. I will launch the ACES using the launcher. Connect to the car and enter the head unit's FDL coding. Set RDC safety string to active and the RDC juke temp to juke on temperature. Save and do the FDL coding. Job done, and enjoy the new option. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.